A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, they celebrated Egg Day. Conveniently, when we celebrate a different kind of Egg Day. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Mystic Starport, our Star Wars game. My name is Philip, and I am the living force because I named the person for this weird basic role-playing system I made. And by basic role-playing, I don't mean it's just like simple basic role-playing. We literally used basic role-playing from Chaosium as our base. Joining me are my wonderful players, some of whom are dragons, some of whom are Star Warsers, but all of whom are going to have a wonderful time tonight. I hope. Boy, I've really oversold it. If they don't, they can get mad at me because I promised it to them. Say Bright Suns, players.
Bright Suns players.
There we go. How's everyone doing tonight?
Dragons tonight? Are we going to play as our dragons in Star Wars?
That would be funny, but no. I think you will be Bug Wowza, and Vonda is going to be, although Vonda, just because of a random name generator, will still have, so Vonda plays Zigzag, spelled with X's in our other game, in the Dragon game, but tonight is Zip. Zip Zissa. So it's going to be fun, and you know what, I actually want to do this. I don't always, I'm going to pull up, because it is it's one of those Star Wars species that you don't all, like, you see, but it's a pretty obscure one, so, like, it's not a thing. I am going to share with the viewers a picture of a Tarnob from episode one, just so they know what they are, because it's kind of fun. So I'll do that in a moment here, but literally we'll just drag that in front of this capture window in a real fancy way. But before we jump into that, I don't know, what do we usually do in this game?
Mischief. Crimes.
All right, so guys,
we have like a
tab.
I am going to do that, by the way. I remembered. I said I remembered. Right. I'm going to remember every single time.
So, friends, this might be my best quick blue milk yet. What I did was I purchased some non-dairy rice. I forget the name of the brand. It's just horchata.
Oh yeah, that's a perfect idea.
Horchata with one little drop of blue, and it turns into this, and it's very refreshing.
I'm telling you, you need to do like just put blueberries in it and shake it.
He doesn't like blueberries, I bet.
I love blueberries. I have a whole thing of them in there, but I would need to blender it, and I
no, also actually, no. Blueberries make it purple.
I was gonna say it's gonna be purple, not blue.
I disagree. I'm gonna do it myself next time.
Please
do it.
No one stop. If you keep, if you say you're gonna do it, then do it.
I'm gonna forget. Someone remind me next week.
I couldn't. It's 2 weeks.
I'll remember.
It's 2 weeks. Yeah.
The poor dragons. Just we had a lot of dragons who'd been the Hey guys, the dragons sure were flying so much. Their wings were tired.
Well, we don't really have them right now, so we're out of practice of flying.
You took away our wings.
I did take away. Take these broken wings, because you've trapped us in a damn domain of dread.
They were not broken. They were perfectly functional, and you took them anyway.
Yes, yes. You stole our perfectly fine wings.
Happy Egg Day to us all, indeed. This game, Mystic Starport, is a fun one because I don't really have to do recaps other than that we are on the planet of Westrena. We are in the city of Mystic Starport. On this extremely, it's a planet of rather temperate temperatures. It can get a little colder, a little more blustery. There are some like heavy winds that will roll in to give it that sort of New English coastal vibe, because that's why we rolled randomly, and that's kind of the look of the place. It's a lot of kind of long, thin land masses. So there's a huge amount of coast. Very sea, a lot of ocean-based stuff, fishing and all of that is very prominent on Westrena. It's a planet just on the edge of the Outer Rim. And it's where we've been checking in a city called Mystic Starport at a bar called Haldir's. Haldir, by the way, is being sought out pretty aggressively in our
by someone I would never have expected.
Well, but there's an out-of-game reason why she's going after Haldir. You could probably guess.
Mm.
Do you know what that is?
Well, I know it's her husband's
character. There you go. That's.
But that's the thing. But I know that she hates the character and everything he does, so that is why it is still surprising.
I think hate is a strong word, but definitely is shocked by and rolls her eyes at. And I'm very excited for him to come into the game and refer to someone as this lady.
KJ?
Yeah. Which is what in the game he referred to her as this lady once, as his character did, and she was so mad. He's like, and this lady keeps telling me what to do, and she's like, I have been your Jedi Master for years. Alright. Oh, anywho, so yes.
Wait, Haldir's a Jedi?
You kinda learned that. He was a Padawan in one timeline. Let's phrase it like that. So
he's still force sensitive here now that I'm remembering that, but I didn't think he was a Jedi.
He was a Jedi Padawan. Anyway. Enough about Haldir. We won't see him tonight. Smash cut to. Yes, so we are going to be going to Haldir's. We have a few characters who we've met before here, so we'll sort of introduce those for the group. And Vonda, we're just going to we speed these along since these are sort of done in one missions. So you can introduce yourself to the characters here in a moment, but we will assume that you are known to them. You know, Mystic Starport is a place where a lot of sort of people doing random jobs are, and just everyone here, you know, just kind of takes whatever work they can get because got to get those credits because those Imperial taxes are sky high. Thanks a lot, Zex Thorin.
You're welcome.
So yes, our players today are Bug Wowza, a Yuzum merchant of Cold War, Clone Wars Antiquities. You can do a wave, Pierce, if you'd like to. There you go. Just showing who's who. I guess it is written there, so that's probably not necessary. We have Zex Thorin, a human diplomat who is a sort of a planetary senator for a planet called Naythor that is, and he's a little bit on the Imperial side of things, or he's downed with what the Empire is saying. And then we have Nol Shaizana, who is our resident artist, fashion designer. And last week, she really got to do some stuff with that while being a part of Naythor Duet. Along with Shay Bimbas, who is sadly not here tonight because she's at a celebration elsewhere. And you are Miri Allen.
Mm-hmm.
And she's also a swooper. So, you know, it's just one of those. It's like if you've met one Miri Allen fashion designer who's really good at swoop racing, you've met them all.
That's fair.
So we have a Yuzum, we have a human, we have a Miri Allen, and then the last character we have is a scoundrel. Always great to have a scoundrel. And I'm just going to very quickly drag this in front of the thing and see how well we could show this off to our viewers so your faces are covered. So this is a Tarnab, and that is what when Vonda rolled random and got one of these real cool individuals. You notice the
we are
the,
not seeing it.
Oh, you are not seeing it. Sorry, it's only for the viewers. I already sent it to you. If you're watching on Twitch, you'll see it over there. But basically, it's,
I see it now.
These are they have the noses of skeletons, kind of like goat hands, basically, and a bunch of horns on their heads, and very furry. So, I'm excited to have one of those. I'm sure you guys have met them many times. Vonda even said that to me. You actually can't smell. You have like an enhanced scent, but it's not one of like your highest stats. But they can smell well. I think it's the same as Yuzum. Do you have a scent thing, Yuzum? Do you have a enhanced scent?
It's basically
as a
like
facet.
Yeah, it's basically. I think what is it? Within 10 meters. I can detect beings.
You can detect beings within 10 meters, and if they have pheromones, you can detect them from even further away, because pheromones are just pouring out of them like bad perfume. So, I'm going to take one more sip of my best brew thus far of Blue Milk. Really do like horchata, guys, because it can be made without...
Horchata is good.
It can be made without dairy, if you choose. So... with that, we are going to have the opening credits scroll. That's another thing. Kathleen Kennedy apparently said in an interview this weekend that all future movies will have a yellow crawl.
Good.
Because I guess...
Oh, interesting.
I guess they were like, We really should have just done those on the other ones. It's got, you know.
Like, I don't know. It made sense to me because they're self-contained things. They're not part of a series of stuff going.
I get it, but I
like Solo and
it's iconic, right?
I think it's like that. Get me in the mood.
I can see arguments for both sides. Yeah, yeah. You know, like it didn't.
So with that, we open with. The Outrider flying down to West Drana. Wipe to Haldir's bar, where I don't know, just for the sake of ease, we will say that all of you are sort of present. You guys are not in a booth. You're at one of those high tables, and you can even be at a couple of nearby high tables where it's easy to, you know, mix, where you could either be up on a stool that's kind of uncomfortable to, like, get on off, or you can just be, like, standing against a table with a thing. But as you're all sort of there hanging out, right now, Haldir is dancing like crazy. His incredibly, like, well-toned body, he is just putting more of what he calls bar oil onto it. And just, like, rubbing the bar oil down. And Haldir is, like, he's this very striking. He's an Arcanian. He's got this, like shock of white hair. And he's just sort of, they're a lot of them are, like, genetically, like, engineered. So you see a lot of, like, similar features amongst the Arcanians. And he's just up there, just dancing like crazy, doing moves that, I mean, you know, it's hard to believe someone has so much physical prowess at moving around. But he's a very good dancer. Body rolls, Lauren. Body roll, body roll. Body roll, body roll, body roll, body roll.
Yeah.
Body roll, two, yep. Three, four. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, there we go. Yeah, yeah, that stuff. But he's doing it, and he's just, and you guys do notice him for a moment while you're speaking of her. He just screams, "I'm the main character!" And he's continuing to dance. One of the Twi'lek bartenders, she's dancing sort of on another side of the bar, but then she kind of hops down and grabs a few drinks and brings them over to you guys and says, "This is a round that for once Nolshe is not paying for."
What a surprise. Who's paying for it?
Oh, that guy over there. He bought a round for the whole bar.
On his tab.
Yes, on his tap.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
That's nice of him. Sort of like, you know, raise my glass in that guy's direction.
Yeah, the same.
All right. Chug my drink.
If you guys raise your glasses to this individual, he kind of, he sort of like waves back sort of in a, he looks a bit, how do I phrase this? He looks kind of very, very nervous to be here. He doesn't seem, he's a human. He's wearing kind of like, sort of like a, he's wearing robes that are of almost of a, like, almost like a religious order type of robe. He's, you know, kind of a, but like, but also for traveling, he's a bit sort of bumbled up. He has a pack next to him. And upon seeing you all wave, he kind of, just kind of, comes over and shifts over to all of you. He's like a young guy. He's probably in his, like, you know, early 20s. Hey. Hi there. Many blessings. Do they say bright suns? Is this the one where they say bright suns to everyone? Is this the planet where they?
I mean, I feel like you can say that on a lot of planets.
I noticed. I'm very observant. I noticed there was only one sun here. I'm not sure. Bright sun, maybe. Hi.
You can say whatever.
Oh, okay. Well, great. I was. I'm actually. Hello. He kind of turns and sees sort of Zip there.
You're not from around here, right?
No. I'm not actually.
It's okay. Not many of us are.
Oh,
you know. That kind of thing. Anyone's
it's
really
like Los Angeles.
Yeah, I've heard of that
transplants.
Yeah. Yeah. I've heard of that system. It's a lot of. Yeah. Okay. Are you all, go ahead, Bug.
Do I recognize his robes at all? You mentioned they're sort of like
you can do a lore roll for it.
which lore. It's terrible. No. Nope, not even
it's,
close.
It seems... actually, what is your lore score?
It's 20.
What did you roll?
52.
Can I try?
I will tell you, even with a 52, you like, I would even, like, spot you some points so that you know it must be something obscure, because there'd probably be a lot of things where I would have given it to you with an easy, which is double your score, but, like, it's you don't even remotely recognize it. If any, I'll say that now that the sort of the seal is open here, if anyone has a lore of 50 or higher, they could go ahead and, like, make the try to do it, but it just from first glance, it's nothing you've ever recognized. Go ahead, Zip and Zex, you can make some lore rolls.
Could I make another roll based on what he's wearing?
I would allow you, yes, this is going to tell you utterly different information, but if you would like to do a fashion design roll that is under your mental talents, and don't forget your built-in bonuses with that. Vonda, I would not recommend doing it for this roll, since this person is likely going to tell you everything you want to know very soon. But just so you're aware, you have something in this game, totally forgot to mention this, called force points. You have 5 of them every session. You can use these to give yourself bonuses on rolls or to re-roll after the fact. They can also prevent damage being taken. So I'll cue you in if that ever, or clue you in if that ever makes sense in any situation. Okay. But for now, what did you roll?
I rolled a 53. What does the 10 means in my orange book next to the lore? There's a 25 in the blue box and 10 in the orange.
Yes, sorry. Yeah, this is probably the thing you had last time. So, a 53 means you have not scored a normal success.
Right.
But in order to do a hard success, you have to roll under your blue number, which is half.
Oh, okay. Gotcha.
And then
an
extreme success you'd have to do under the
got
red.
Got it.
Now you also can spend your luck to get, so, like, if you wanted to, but I think you suspect you need better than just normal success. Zex, how did you do on your
37.
37. A 37 is a normal success for you, so I'll say both Zip maybe not as perfect. Zip's kind of like, I have no idea. Zex, you are confident that this is not a prominent religious order, and it is certainly one that is not particularly pronounced, like, either on Nathor or in the core or in sort of places like that. Nolshe, okay. What did you roll on your clothing design?
23, which is a hard success.
23, a hard success. Well, good for you. Whoop-de-doo. With your knowledge of fashion design, you can tell that these robes he's wearing are light blue in color. You suspect that they are given kind of like the uneven, almost, it's not quite like an ombre effect, but you suspect that these were like hand dyed, possibly as like by, this was not done in a like serious textile manufacturing. The cloth is simple loomed cloth. It's fairly well made. It's very durable, plenty of layers. It's well constructed, but it is not off the rack. It's not something you'd get in like a supply run. This is something that is made, you know, on a location. The cut is it's something where they clearly will update the cut of it here or there just so that it reflects, like, just so they don't super stand out. Like, it's not like he's wearing like a doublet and pantaloons or whatever, but it's like, you know, it's just kind of like within the last 50 years, somebody probably like said, okay, people are wearing their cloaks like this, so ours can still count if we do it like that, sort of a thing. So, Nolshe, you suspect it is something that he or someone he knows handmade, not with pretty kind of like basic rustic material, but that it is intended to serve both some religious affiliation while also making it so you're not absurdly conspicuous.
So I also know.
Oh, sorry. Do I get any indication of like where his ranking might be within the religious organization based on the simplicity or the dye or something?
I think that is. I think you don't have, even with a hard, you don't know enough about that culture to know if, You know, there are some people where, like, the highest ranked person wears a plain white thing, and it's like, you know, so like, yeah, it is.
I'd have to know about it.
Yeah, you'd have to know more. It's like, there's a couple buttons here or there, but it's not super complex. Zex, did you have a question as well?
And I also, like, at least get the idea that he's like a religious.
I think person. Yes. I think with your role, you can tell this is probably like a pilgrim of some type, but is a religious person. But he's sort of coming over to you all. Hi, hello, yes, hi.
So you're a man of the cloth.
Oh yeah, yes. I am just a humble traveler, but I am in need of some assistance. And I have purchased a round for the people in this because the fellowship tells us to be generous. But
do you normally sweat this much when you talk?
I'll elbow the senator to be like, be nice.
Sometimes it depends on the circumstances. I've been looking for help, and I've come into various of these bars, which are very colorful and strange in their ways, but I am looking for some assistance here on a planet
such
as this.
What do you need help with?
Oh, I need help with I just need some security.
Oh.
Like guards or
I don't simply need muscle. I just need to find some kind-hearted individuals who can assist me with some security, and I can pay you I cannot pay you rather, the amount of credits I can pay you with is not substantial, but I can pay you in some rather interesting objet d'art.
Well, what do you need protection from?
Oh, we do not that is to say, it was we and now it is only me. Oh dear.
And I'll offer the stool that I was sitting on. Why don't you have a seat.
Oh gosh. Okay.
Oh, you do have a drink. Okay. Good. Yeah.
Oh, just a blue milk for me. It's, you know.
Okay. So you want another?
Oh, I am. Oh no, I am the one purchasing drinks for the thing. And sure enough, the fellowship says to be kind, especially this time of the cycles. And lo and behold, you acknowledged me. So you were the ones.
Well, I agree
come
with
to.
That teaching of the fellowship. I'm extending my kindness to you as well.
Have you heard of the Fellowship of Kuru?
I've not heard of it, but the teachings do sound intriguing.
Oh well, they are. It's an old order. It's an oldie, but a coldie, because it's so old. It's cold. Yes. So, I must perform a ritual, just a few hours. I'm trying to keep to Vaini time, which is where I am from, the planet of Vaini. It is an important time of year, for us.
Happy,
I hope so.
Whatever time of year it is.
Well, it
for
is
you.
It is egg day.
Oh, egg. What is an egg?
Egg day?
Egg day. Yes, egg day is our most important celebration for the Fellowship of Kuru. When we sort of celebrate the eggs and the all the eggs symbolize and ooh, here, would you like some egg candies? And he starts pulling out egg candies for you all.
This all sounds incredibly familiar.
Does it?
Yes.
Do you remember? I was just curious if you, because you guys went to Vaini in another game off stream. Here's gonna.
Yes.
Look, you can't see the yellow, but I was in there.
Oh.
There it is. I really like the mini Cadbury creams. I gotta say,
they're so good.
So good. If any of you would like to take some of these candy eggs he's handing out.
Oh, I'll take
some. I'll take
sure.
one. I'll inspect it very...
They're good. They're, you know, it's candy. They're very sweet. He says, yes, it is egg day. And we will rehatch tomorrow, I've sort of been not way late on this planet. This is simply the planet that I'm on, and I just need I have rented a small storage unit, and I just require someone to guard it or not guard it, just to be outside of it and make sure that I am okay and I am not disturbed inside.
I mean, that sounds like guarding it, but that's fine. We can do that. That's not.
I mean,
below us.
No problem.
Actually, I have to admit, this doesn't sound like work for a senator. But tell me more about this art you're offering us.
Oh,
well,
yes, of course.
This bar isn't a bar for a senator either, and here you are.
But you're a senator. Yeah. I thought this was I thought senator was like a funny nickname. You were. You're a senator. Oh, that is so important. Oh dear.
I like this guy.
Also, I'm not entirely sure about that Nullshay. I'm pretty sure I've seen some other senators dancing with some of the bartenders.
Yes, but if it would have become known to their, you know, people. Think they would have.
This is fair.
This is the Empire. Fair. There's not much they can do.
That's fair. Oh. Anyway, what are we looking at?
Oh,
about the art.
Of my artwork, yes, of course. Well then, I would happily let's see. This is very on point. This is an important item, but it has no specific relevance. It's just a cultural significance, but not the one we'd be happy to. Or you know, he pulls out a small egg. It's about this big. It is covered in gems, like an obscene amount of gems. Opens the top of it, and inside there's a little. Like hovering crystal sort of spinning, you know, it's got some kind of simple little anti-grav thing. It's just kind of like a little, like a dazing like thing. Yes, go ahead, Bugwaza.
Oh, okay. I'd like to appraise this.
Sure.
I was also going to say, like, can any of us make a roll to see if we recognize, or is this thing like...
This is Bugwaza is a merchant, so this is what he's for.
Okay.
let's go ahead and spend 5 luck to make it an extreme success.
Oh, okay. This is, as far as the appraisal, this is worth, these are not the most expensive gems, but the settings are very good.
Expensive.
you suspect you could get, you know, 1,500 credits for this without issue. Mm.
And, that's a very, fine, sculpture, there. Will we each be receiving one of these, or is this the...
Oh, I will. I mean, if you all just want one of these, oh, sure, certainly. I had if people preferred, let's... Oh, well, we got a, he then pulls out a small... Some people really like these. He pulls out this, like, onyx statuette that has kind of, these like veins of a strange green material in there. Bug, I'm going to save you some time. Every single thing he shows you is worth 1,500 credits.
Okay.
Okay.
I will say just to the group here, I think, any one of these artworks would probably cover our usual fee about. So if that's intriguing to you at all, and if any of you need help, if you want to hold on to it, sure, but if you need help sort of turning that artwork into credits, sort of something I do. But it seems like a fairly simple, straightforward job for a pretty decent payout.
Sure.
I'm game.
Yep, sure.
Can I do a psychology roll on the religious guy?
Please make a psychology roll on him.
45.
I think that's a normal success for you.
Yeah.
Yeah. He is very nervous. I think with a normal success, you can sense a tension within him, a tension about whether or not you can be trusted. You're not exactly sure what it all means or where it's coming from, but he just seems very nervous about all of this, and he just needs to make Egg Day go well. He just needs to have a good Egg Day.
So, and we all.
graciously accept.
Oh, you will? Oh, thank you so much, Senator. Wow, that's so kind. I'll be guarded by a real senator. Oh, sorry, I'm going to eat more eggs because I'm
very
nervous.
You are truly privileged to have this opportunity, but it's fine. It's fine.
It's the... I cannot wait to rehatch tomorrow, the fellowship is... This will really help the fellowship. I am so grateful. I feel this has been ordained by the shell itself.
Uh-huh. Is there anyone that you expect to be interrupting you?
Well, no.
Something specific we should look out for?
Well,
literally just...
As long as there's no random thugs.
I'm going to turn to Bug and say, I feel it feels like there's going to be a catch. Do you feel like there's going to be a catch?
I am convinced there will be a catch.
Yeah.
When is there not? Look at the galaxy we live in. There's always random bugs.
I know it's going to be here, so we're on familiar territory. I just can't see it being that dangerous.
Well,
what is life without danger?
Very good. Well, here's the little storage unit on the edge of town I'm in. I'll just, you know, come there and just in about 3 hours, that would be a great time for you to begin the guarding, and then I'll give you these items, and I'm so excited about this. And he says, may the blessings of the eggs, may the shells unfold and your hatchings always be smooth. And
Okay. Well, happy Egg Day. We'll see you.
Happy Egg Day Eve. It's almost Egg Day. He just kind of wanders away.
Nice. Strange.
Mm-hmm. What a cool little man.
Think he's actually gonna hatch, or is that just like a?
I've seen stranger.
Who knows? Maybe.
All I can say, he's probably hiding something, and I want to find out. I'm intrigued.
Dash walks in and goes, "Oh, hey. Hey, everybody. Good to see you guys. Hey, Noel.
Dash.
Zach said, you're really spending a lot of time here, man. Hey, Bug, how's it going?
All right.
How are you? Oh, I'm not sure we've met. I'm Dash. Oh, I think I've seen you around. Are you Zigzag? Is that your name?
No. It's Zip.
Zip, sorry.
Just
sorry about that. Dash Rendard, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Yeah, cool. I've seen you around the bar. Well, as luck would have it, I was looking for a crew. I got a job here. If you guys want to head off,
how much?
Oh, do you already take a job?
Well, yeah, but
then say no more. I never poach.
You're not poaching. We have 3 hours.
Oh, no. We're going off world. He sort of turns around and goes, "Hey, guys, I need some people to come be test listeners at a music festival." And then he just starts listing all of the hottest bands. We're just supposed to go hang out with them and every other hand in the place. And Haldir flips off and goes, "I'll come." Oh, all right, Haldir. And Kyle's like, wait, is this a guy's trip? Kyle Katarn is coming out like, is this a boy's trip? Boy's trip? Brash and Corellians are be doing it? And Dash goes, "I guess you guys deserve it. All right, come on, guys." Haldir's like, "I'm the main character again." He's like, "All right, well, good luck on your job. I hope it's good." Also, there's this like super amazing chef who's supposed to be catering the whole thing for us. It's gonna be great. Okay, I like food. Oh, yeah, I do too, Haldir. That's really cool. Yeah, I like food. Do you hear, Dash? I like it too. I heard, buddy. Come on. So they all start walking out, and just like a crowd of people are following them. Like, got room for one more? Subtitles. I like food too.
Look, on the one hand, that sounds fun. On the other hand, we would have to spend time with Haldir and Kyle outside of this bar. And that is not something I will ever do.
Well,
same.
Dash,
I have a question.
Dash would not have offered it to them had you guys accepted, but, you know, yeah. Yes, go ahead, Zex.
While that was happening, can I sneak away from the table and go order drinks at the bar?
Make a sneak roll.
I'm ready. I want to.
Please make a
sneak roll. Battled a TikTok, too.
I got a 27. Let's go.
What is a 27 for you in
sneak? Hard success.
Hard success. All right. So here is the problem for you, my friend.
Uh-oh. No.
Noel Shea has an 83 in look and has a bonus on it. So Noel Shea, you don't hear him get up, but you spot like one shadow moving the opposite direction and you see him at the bar. So if you want to intercede, you have spotted it in time.
Is the bartender that I talked to last time there?
Roll a D4. Roll a D4.
This is about to be a lot of rolls. We're about to have a battle.
It's going to be a fight. The whole thing is just a fight here.
A D4. I got a 2.
That is Bothri the Intense One. I think you were talking to Naidu last time.
Oh, okay.
Actually, wait, hold on. It might have been Bothri.
I think it was.
It was either the Intense or the Feisty One. I think
no, shit, this is happening.
I think it was Naidu. Hold on. Yes, it was Naidu.
So it's the one at the bar.
It's no, Bothry is at the bar.
Oh, okay.
Naidu so is I'm... one, this is two. Sorry. So it's not the one you've talked to. He's talking.
Then I'm gonna run up to the bar okay. and say, no more drinks on my tab. None. Zero.
What?
I haven't ordered anything yet.
I'm closing my tab right now.
Oh, you're closing your tab.
Yeah, and I'll quickly send her.
Oh, no, Mr. Rendar already closed it out. He said it was part of a bet. And then he said otherwise we could have seen you dancing on the table.
That is true, and I did win that bet, and I would like my tab to remain closed.
Well, yes, we cannot open the tab on your behalf. So there is currently no tab open for you.
Okay. Okay, go ahead, Senator. You want to order?
But please.
Sure, you can go back to the table. You don't have to watch me order a drink.
But because this is the intense one, Bothry will pause and say, but Nolshe, never run up to me again like that.
I'm just such a huge fan of you.
I don't believe that's why.
She is a bit of a liar, but you know, I heard that from Dash.
You're a senator. You can afford to buy your own drinks, right?
I never said I wasn't buying my own drink. I was just walking to the bar. You run over. I feel attacked. What's going on? No, were we cool?
Go ahead and order.
All right. I don't like someone breathing down my neck, though. You can go back to the table.
I'll just take one step to the side, but stay at the bar.
So, Zip, you like history?
Can I?
About the...
Sure.
I want to whisper to the bartender. I want to ask him, hey, are you a gambling man?
Bothry will just, she'll just stare back at you like,
only when life is on the line.
Luckily, I like to bet big.
Is there a game? I don't understand.
Listen, how about if we come back from this mission? And I don't know, never mind. Next time. I just order a drink. I pay for it on mine. I look back at Nolshe. Like, not menacingly, but I just, you know, I give her like a side eye. Like,
yeah, fair enough. Bug, you were talking about history.
Oh, yeah. Zip, you're just sort of new here, so I don't know if you like history. I know a lot about the Clone Wars. It's sort of my specialty. I don't know if you want to hear anything about that. Or actually, what do you do, Zip?
I'm into import-export.
Oh, a bit of that myself. I'm a merchant. I specialize in Clone War memorabilia and antiquities. So I do a bit of that myself, much smaller
you
scale.
You have a shop?
Yeah, I've got a shop here, but I kind of am a little mobile. Mm. I kind of keep inventory here, but I do dealings all over the place.
Inventory. You have to tell me all about it.
Well, the good news about my inventory is that you have to, it's only valuable if you know the right people. It's not like a stack of precious gems or metals.
Many people.
So you guys can, of course, kind of kill an hour or two, but basically it's before too long if you want to take like a nice kind of walk around. You know, you could hire a speeder or Nolshe. You might take your bike there, but otherwise it's like a 30-minute walk to where he is, kind of on the outskirts of Mystic Starport. So you guys can go and find this young pilgrim. We'll sort of do a wipe to you sort of arriving at one of these sort of, you know, just a little like storage facility, almost warehouse type things on a pier. And or like next to docks and piers and things, and he is just at the one you sort of saw, and as you approach, he says, "Oh, good, you're here. I'm so excited. Hello and welcome. Many Egg Day blessings for you all. I appreciate you're all here. I have a really good feeling about this. I think this is gonna just this is just gonna scramble up nicely." That's just one of the terms of the
Made the egg be with you.
Mm. Oh, well, the egg is always is with me. Always. But yes, so anyway, I don't know how if you want to split up or how you want to defend this, but basically he sort of shows you there's just like a storage facility. There's like a sliding down sort of door thing. It's like a pretty, it's not like a blast door or anything. You notice there's a couple of crates, and there's a, they're inside, you can see there is a large egg that is about a meter in size that's sort of glowing softly. Kind of like a very low glow, and it's like kind of next to a couple of crates, and he has some material set up around that. And he is, just sort of, he's wearing his blue rose, looking now as this like kind of like additional like kind of like darker blue piece, which Noel say you probably assume is, you know, some like more formalizing element. And he's just showing that to you guys. He's just, so he's gonna be in here, and we'll just you just be out here and just make sure I don't get interrupted.
Sounds good.
Okay. Yeah. Great.
Can I roll something to, do I suspect what's in the boxes or crates or whatever they are?
The crates? I don't, you'd have to, like, do a little more snooping, they don't appear to be, I'll
can
tell
I
you
snoop?
What, you can do, why don't you, I'll let you either make a look roll, which will just kind of let you know if you like see specific things that are help. Oh, actually, no. Let's let you lean into your strength. Would you please make a luck roll? Let's see if any of these crates have like insignia that you recognize.
Okay,
look.
Is it a D100?
So it's a D100, still? And you are trying to roll. You see your luck. It's actually on the top column next to your armor. And you get a. You get to roll a bonus on this automatically. Because of your being a scoundrel and being a lucky duck.
Hang on. Luck. Okay.
So your target score is 70, but if you can roll in under a 35, it becomes hard. If you can roll under a 14, it becomes extreme.
And I have a advantage in it, so I can roll 3.
No. So you guys, roll. Or? You roll only one of the ones column. So you roll only one of those, but then you roll two mm-hmm. of these and pick the lower.
Two in the 100 column. Okay.
Yeah, two, yeah.
So, okay, I rolled a 00 and a 10
okay.
in the thingy and a 3.
So you've rolled a 3.
So, 00 is 0 and not 100.
Yes, it is. Yeah, if you roll a 0 on the other one, that is 100. But at that point, you have rolled a 3, which for you, with a score of 70, congratulations, is under 5%, or is under the 120th score. That is a vital success, so congratulations. So, with a vital success, you just are so lucky, Zip. It's how to make it as a smuggler, is to just be really lucky. You recognize some of the, you don't necessarily recognize what the crates are or what they're for, but you do recognize like the shipping ident code types on these.
Okay.
You know that this is from a rather low rent commercial carrier who charges extremely high rates, so you suspect this is a person who was just getting various materials around the outer rim. Sort of going to some kind of like probably went through a commercial thing rather than just tried to find, you know, like a private, probably couldn't afford hiring a ship. So they had a bunch of stuff shipped freight, but the rates are very sort of predatory. So basically, I think with your luck of just know, so, and like, and since this is vital, you know, just based on this and seeing thing, you're like, oh, perfect. You know, this person has been here for like exactly 2 weeks and got like, has probably stranded here. And you can paint the whole story for yourself just because you're like, oh, I know all about this company. I've stolen a bunch of stuff from them. That kind of vibe. Yeah.
Okay.
So, but he's kind of just, well, thank you so much. I very much appreciate it. However you want to do it, just please just don't disturb me during the process. That's all I ask. Just don't let me be disturbed. It's just so important that Egg Day goes well. this year. The way of Kuru is the way of peace, okay? Just so you're all aware. Just the way of Kuru is the way of peace, my friends. Thank you. He shakes each of your hands or paws, you know, very like, thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Real direct eye contact in that real like youth minister fellowship sort of way. Thank you. Yeah.
How long will the hatching take? Is it?
It's the egg day hatching. I have to sing. I am going to be performing. I would invite you to attend, but I really need you guys guarding. I'm going to perform, even though it is only me left. I am going to perform. I was asking people if anyone wanted to sort of join the fellowship. But I understand it's a very old religion, and it's not really from here. No one's just from Vaini or even the surrounding sectors. So, but I just have to. I have to perform the entire rite of the festival of Ovigorius. So,
I'm sorry, you're the only one left?
Well, of my group.
Yeah.
Some of the people couldn't even get on the last ship that brought us here, and they haven't been able to get a comm out. But I've just, as long as the ceremony goes okay, then there's hope for the future of the Fellowship of Kuru.
Fellowship.
Yeah, thank you so much. Well, the way of Kuru is the way to peace. All right, I appreciate all the hatching. I'm just going to perform this, festival. Thank you.
Get on in there.
Thank you so much. Just kind of closes it and just sort of says, go forth, newly hatched. And closes the gate.
Any way to spy on him?
It is at this point that you guys see, you see a large figure coming down the street. Large, clunking, metallic footsteps coming, and all of you, I think all of you probably have, but especially those of you with, like, listen scores over 50, you're all like, oh, your hackles are really raised, and you're sort of like, before you even think of a means of, like, spying, you're like, oh, what's going on? But then
I'm taking out my heavy blaster.
You see this massive class 5 droid walking here, and atop it is a Jawa with a jetpack named Zaz.
Ootiri.
Hi, Zaz.
Hi.
Ootiri.
Ootini.
Just out for a stroll.
Yeah, we was just looking for some scrap. Saw a couple nice scoop bikes in front of the bar. I thought about taking some of that stuff.
Doing like a storage auction kind of thing. Is that one's?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. You didn't take mine.
No, of course not.
You better not, Zaz.
No, so did you walk here or did you ride here?
I walked with everyone.
You walked with everyone. Well, the end, yeah. So, I don't even know what Zaz has done. Go ahead and make a psychology roll.
Oh no.
Zaz, if you took parts of her bike, I'll definitely buy them off you. We could talk later if you did.
I got a regular success.
Okay.
I would never.
Yeah. You don't think he stole anything from you.
I want to like flash some credits at Zaz, just like give him a look like, did you?
Just give him a nod.
I'm gonna.
Whoa! No one said you saw that. No one said you saw that.
Her look is really high. I don't know. She might have.
Ooh.
Zaz. As you sort of come to the group. Actually, I'll tell you what. Why don't you give me a luck roll?
Roll?
Yeah. What you might have heard. Because you are just on the prowl for some scrap, but let's see what you might have, what potentially passed your ears or your glowing yellow eyes on the way over. Also, Kevin, do you know Vonda? Vonda's here. I don't know if you've ever played with Vonda before.
Once.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, good. Well, yeah.
I rolled a 41, and I realized I had the wrong sheet open.
Oh, perfect. Well, not, 41 is
this
eight.
Is not long last lore.
It is sadly not, sadly, or also excitingly not that, depending on perspective. Zaz, with that role, you know you did actually overhear. You weren't necessarily coming here to join them, but you heard that Bug and Nolshe and Zex and some Tarnob you vaguely are familiar with accepted some weird job like minutes before Dash showed up saying he needed people to come to basically work a like food and wine tasting and like exclusive concert at some like luxury planet. So he took Haldir and Kyle Katarn and others. So that he's long gone at this point with them, but this crew is here doing some like small scale job. Nobody even no one even asked about it. So you've bumped into them, but you don't even know what they're up to.
I'll ask Bug, since I think he's the only one who can understand me.
Yeah, I think here I'm the only one who speaks. Can I
assess Zez whether he would be worse, shaking down and,
The thing
hit on the head and...
The thing that makes you think Zaz would not be worth shaking down is the 2.5 meter tall... labor droid he's riding on with reinforced plating and all that. You suspect that he's, he has resources to make him a better person to be friends with than to rob from.
I do the robbing here.
Yeah.
So I'll explain. Zaz, we took a job. All we have to do is sort of stand guard over this. A storage unit, and we'll end up getting a piece of art that's worth about 1,500 credits. Seemed like you had a bunch of it, so I'm sure if you want to join in and help, you'd probably end up with some as well. As the rest of you all hear, I say, Utini.
Utini. Utini. The droid is just going, Utini.
We just have to stand here?
And just make sure that whatever he's doing in there, whatever religious ceremony he's performing in there, it doesn't get interrupted. Didn't sound like anyone was really coming for him, but they kept saying like not a lot of his group survived or made it here. So I don't know if they're being picked off.
Religion.
Just a lone crackpot with a bunch of art. I'm in.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. I mean, we got to figure out like how we want to guard this. You know.
How many entrances sort of are there into this thing?
This is imagine like. Imagine like a, it's like, this is like kind of like a long building, with these sort of like, you know, like big doors that you could open and put sort of stuff inside. It's really akin to like the exterior section of like a public storage, you know, there's just a bunch of like gates and sort of stuff can go in there. It's that kind of facility. And so there's, as far as you can tell, there's only one entrance into that room. You don't know, you haven't like fully cased the place. You could walk around the other side of the building, see if there's windows or things like that. Those of you with high looks didn't notice like a window on the other side when you were opening it. It seems to be like a, you know, just like a little warehouse room. You are probably about 200 feet from the water, kind of in the opposite, like when the thing opens, it's facing the water. And it is a, ooh, fun, I rolled high. It happens to be, it's raining. It's kind of one of those, it's beginning to rain a little bit, which is going to limit visibility to some extent, but nothing too crazy. It's not storming or anything, but it's just, there's a sort of, which Jawas probably don't care for that.
Yeah.
Seems like we got one main entrance. Maybe we should just patrol and have some people here.
Is anyone particularly good at range? I'm much more of a close up. Well, most of my best combat skills are close up or talking my way out of it.
I'm good at blasters.
And I'm also good with heavy blasters.
So then perhaps.
I'm good as well, I think.
Perhaps anyone that's sort of good at long range, we just sort of post you in some lookout spots so you can take shots and stuff for that. I'm not sure if it's better for our melee people to stand by the entrance or to stand over here.
We should probably. Spread around and kind of hide in the shadows. You know, not to be too obvious that we are just standing here. Maybe
that's
one
true.
Or
we probably
people
shouldn't be...
could be obvious and the other
Actually, ones. Actually, there's an interesting idea there, is that you sort of gave me. we should guard a different room. So if anyone comes for us, we're decoying them over to another spot. Someone should stand guard over just not this room.
I was thinking we should go into some of these other units too.
I'm sure you were, Zach.
Not into them, just protecting them.
She said we should go inside.
I did say we should guard it, but I understand what's going to happen, Zaz. I'm just asking that you keep some focus over here as well.
Is it multi-level building or a single level?
Single floor.
Okay.
Climb up on top?
Sure. If you want to kind of get up on the roof, Zip, go ahead and make a climb roll. That's under your physical talents, the middle column, the third one over.
And is it a fairly solidly built building?
Yeah, it's a, Duracrete, kind of just like, it's a somewhat prefab kind of thing, but in the style of here. What did we roll, Zip?
I rolled an 82.
An 82, so basically, Zip, you start trying to, climb up, kind of at a thing, but, it's just, it's so slick.
Slippery.
And it's raining, and you're just kind of, you can't really get up Damn there. They probably build these, so it's not super easy to just kind of climb up on top, so, yeah, you're unfortunately unable to.
And Torg, give her a boost.
Yes, if you will, however, permit upon that. If Zaz kind of nudges the droid, this labor droid kind of walks over to you and very slowly, kind of just moves its hands down and goes, "Utini, Utini."
I step on it, Utini.
Kind of the head pivots eerily back to Zaz.
She doesn't mean it.
And Zip, you are thrown up on the roof. Make an acrobatics roll.
Okay. 34.
Yes, and this you are able to kind of now that you, it's, you know, it's a, it's, yeah. You kind of do a nice little roll, land, you're up on the roof. You see there are, there are little exhaust fans over each of the facilities. If you walk to the back, you actually see that there is a, there's just an alley back there, and as far as you can tell, there's no windows.
If I go to the exhaust fan, can I hear what's going on?
Sure, downstairs? Make a listen roll.
Okay. Ooh, that's pretty nice, 21. And that is a very good roll for me.
Is it blue, under the blue number?
Blue.
Under the blue, that is a hard success. Excellent. So yes. So Zip, you sort of listen at the thing, and with a hard success, you still can't really make out what's going on because there's this loud whoosh, whoosh sound. But you can hear under that young man is in the process of speaking a strange language, in a very sort of ritualistic way. And occasionally it sounds like he's even softly singing. He's kind of going, Anovasana Kuru. And Timeamana Kuru Ovagorus Ima. That's not him, that's the sound of the fan. But it probably makes it easier for Zipti. Yeah.
Well, I guess while they're doing that, some of us should
sounded very Gregorian.
It does.
I was guessing some of us should maybe patrol, get a lay of the land.
Nolshe?
I'll patrol as well.
So Nolshe and Zex will have you two patrolling. Zip is going to be up on top, kind of looking out for there and can move from there. But it seems
I'm
Bug...
I'm trying to be, hiding.
Understood. So, stealthy up there. Perfect. Stealthy, Bug, yeah. You and Zaz were going to go to a different facility nearby. Is that the idea?
Well, just a different unit.
Not a different building. Are you going adjacent? Or are you going two over?
I'll go adjacent to it.
Okay.
And I'll stand here. You're welcome to stay. I have a feeling you're just gonna.
I'm gonna start opening it.
Yeah, the one next to him.
Yeah,
the one that he's at. Okay, cool. Great. So a few things going on here. We have the people. We have Zaz doing what Zaz does. We have Zip up on top, kind of keeping an eye on things. Zip, I'm gonna say, given that it's raining and that you are already on top and that your sneak is a 77. I will say it's actually easy to remain hidden up there for now, so no roll is required yet, but under certain circumstances you might need to do this. But basically, if you're just kind of posted there and listening and keeping an eye out, you're in a good position. Zaz, you... Also, Vonda, I forgot to tell you a very important thing to do, which I'm now going to click off. Have you succeeded? I'm so sorry, Vonda. Do you recall, did you succeed at any specific talents? I know you succeeded at that acrobatics you just did. Did you make any other rolls where you succeeded that you can remember?
What did I do?
There was a 3 on that. Oh, but that was luck.
It was luck, so yeah, luck automatically gets it, yeah.
I'm sure it succeeded. It was less than 52.
Yeah, you succeeded at acrobatics, but basically, so, since I forgot to tell you this, whenever you succeed at a thing but you don't have to spend other stuff, you get to click the little box next to it, because that means you get to improve it at the end. Sorry, that's just on me. So we might have missed one, but I don't think we did. We'll add those if we do. All right, so we have Zip up there holding it
down.
Well,
the look, I succeeded it. Should I?
And click look as well.
Well, listen.
Oh, yeah, you succeeded at listen. Exactly, you literally just did. More recently, the acrobatics. Succeed at that. All right, so I'm going to say even... will be patrol, odd will be, and it is the patrol. So Zex and Nolshe, you guys are walking around doing a basic patrol. Nolshe, why don't you do a look roll and remember to give yourself your bonus. Zex, what would you like to roll as part of this patrol? You can use one of your sense talents, but if you had a different thing you sort of wanted to try, you could do that instead.
I guess... You know what? I'll do... I have nothing for it. I'm going to wait for... I'll also just look as well.
Okay, do a look. Perfect.
I just got a regular success.
Regular success. And I'll show you you're going to look around. Even with your bonus?
Yeah.
Cool.
Let's see. I got a 20.
Oh.
That is hard success.
Hard success. So yeah. So Nolshe, you're kind of... You're keeping your eyes around here. Zex is your sort of like looking about you, you spot that there is a sort of like a hover bus stop kind of down the end of the sort of pier about 100-150 meters away in the rain. It has stopped there and several people have gotten off at it, but none of them are coming specifically in this direction. Nolshe, you clock that, but for the most part, that the alleyway behind is clear. Neither of you see any windows that lead into that facility. There's a few people around, but now that it's raining, most people are sort of, you know, heading indoors.
I'll ask Nolshe, I think you're more familiar with this planet than I am still. How busy does this area get, if you know?
Am I familiar with this area?
Make a look roll. I forget.
Wait,
to have
luck
people.
Luck. Oh, mine's low now.
Yeah, we'll just see if
I'm one of the newest people in the group.
81.
Right. 81. You. So I'm going to tell you what you know, but you may say whatever you want. You have never been here before. You've never been to this neighborhood.
Okay. I haven't been around here very much.
Boring. I wanted you to say, I come here all the time.
Right? Sure. So you don't get out very much. I guess that makes sense.
I get out plenty, thank you.
Seem like a swoop bike nerd, but yeah, you're, I guess.
And swoop bikes are made for travel as well. Very handy when it comes to getting from one destination to another, incidentally.
That's very true. I hope it's still there. I really do.
Zaz.
So you guys, are you just gonna like circle the building? It's a pretty long... You know, it's like a long building, so you can sort of circle it, patrol, but it might take you, 10 minutes to sort of do a loop and get back to the front.
Just do like a loop.
Yeah. Well, you guys are there, Bug and Zaz. You are at the adjacent facility. Zaz, you're going to try to open it. How are you going about opening the door? You are muted, sorry.
What kind of lock mechanism is it?
It does not appear... It appears to be a rather basic, there's just like a clamp lock on one side. You just punch in a code and it releases. kind of.
So
deal.
I can't like lockpick type thing.
You could try to lockpick.
Try that.
You have the pickpocket skill, right? Or no?
Yeah, it's in the fine motor.
Fine motor skill. Sorry, it's, yeah. In this game, fine motor skills is picking locks and then and like pickpockets when you're trying to do something no one can see it. So you go ahead and do a fine motor skills as you try to just like pop the thing.
I'm just gonna.
You got a four.
Oh. A four.
Yeah.
So, what is your score in fine motor skills?
87.
87. So that's a vital success for you because it's a 20th or lower. So basically, Bug, you just see and like the droid kind of, and he just gets down there and, you know, Bug, you were about to say something.
Oh, I was just saying that I'm just keeping a nose out in case I smell anything unfamiliar.
Understood. So you're like something here, and but so Zaz, you kind of just reach it, just do, and it pops. Now, you don't think it's like an automated thing. You are seeing like an error code pop up on the console. Because you have like tripped it, but like you've done it in such a way that like nothing's damaged. You even like you can then like you can probably like, click a thing back in, and honestly, with a vital, we'll say you can do that and just like shimmy something into the sensor, and it thinks it's closed, and then you can open it, no problem. Within Bug, you picked this facility, so would you please roll a luck for me?
That's a no-go.
How good a no-go?
It's 67. So 42 is my luck, 67. So,
okay. So it's not crazy, but you have very bad luck, so okay. So you open it. Both of you are hit.
Of course I do.
With a pretty intense stench.
Ooh.
Ugh. And in this room, in kind of like gross moldering piles, there are reptile skins.
Ugh.
There's also like blood on the inside of some. I mean, you just see it. It's like there's definitely some flies and things in here. It's intense.
Does it look like?
Why did you pick this one?
I just chose one that was advantageous for our.
You didn't smell that?
No. I'm not so great smelling through Durasteel.
Yeah. Seems reasonable.
Does it look like a crime happened here? Does it look like this was just some sort of shedding metamorphosis situation?
Make a
poachers then. Maybe it's a delicacy for some.
Do you
reasons.
Have a, do you have calculate?
I do have calculate.
Yeah, make a calculate. Are you halfway decent at calculate, maybe calculate. Yeah, I will say 70. Zip, given your nose. So basically a few minutes after all this starts, you know, you're mainly just up there keeping out. You are hit with this like distant but very gross smell of like rotten lizard.
Regular success for calculate.
Regular success for calculate. It doesn't appear to, you don't think it's a crime scene, although it may be very illicit. This seems to more be just like a bunch of like hastily collected lizard skins, some of which have not been like tanned or preserved at all. You even notice if you kind of like you guys are like stepping in and looking around, one of them has like part of a Trandoshan face on it. So like, ugh. Yeah, it's pretty.
Zaz, sorry, I think we're in like yet another situation where this is valuable if you know the right people.
Yeah,
I don't know the right people for this. I don't want to know the right people for this, if I'm honest.
Yeah, I can't even handle it. I'll choose the rain.
You close this one?
But, yeah. I mean, there's like doors over there and there if you want to keep. I know you're going to, so I'll just keep an eye out in case stuff happens.
Put the helmet on too, just to see if that can just
sure.
block the stench.
Filter it out.
Oh, if you're, I taste it. I can taste it.
Although now you can, now everyone can talk to you because you have your translator.
Yes.
All right. So, so Zip, you're up top. Are you guys going to go to a different door?
Yeah.
All right. So you will. Did you go
how,
right?
Like, how far away are these, like, from each other?
They're like about. Each one's about like. 5 meters apart, you know?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I was sort of in my head envisioning like public storage, so I was just imagining.
Like close.
Yeah.
They're a little further apart than that.
Okay, but there we're still within like.
Oh, you're visual. You could go visual. A few away, and you could sort of see the okay. one you're after. Yeah.
Then Zaz, I clearly don't have the luck. Go ahead and pick the next one, I guess. I'll go and I'll just kind of walk with him and like keep a lookout and a nose out.
It's gonna go two down the other direction.
Two down the other direction. So okay, so pass the one, skip one, go to that one. Great. Zaz, go ahead and make another fine motor skills.
A one.
Okay. So this time you pick it at the same time as slipping in the thing, so there's not even an instant in which anything even like any like alert comes on, and you roll it up. Give me a luck roll now, Zaz.
Nice. 35.
What is your luck score?
65, so it's just a regular
success. All right, cool. You open this one. This one has a bunch of like comm equipment. It's got a lot of like comm handles, but you can tell they don't have like receivers put in, so all the apparatus of that. You also see some like larger scale receivers and broadcasters. There's a bunch of communications tech. You suspect it is surplus. You know, probably something that is probably like kind of stuff somebody made some deal and then buyer backed out, or they had the wrong size. It was just, you know, they're literally just storing it here until they can do something with it.
What a load of junk.
Yeah.
But what would someone do with all those lizard skins anyways? That was just...
Rugs? Oh, we should ask Nolshay if they make clothes out of them.
Oh. Can she sell them?
I mean, maybe. I don't know what her particular, like... I don't understand fashion as well as she does, so...
We should send her in there.
Yeah, we should show it to her and see what she thinks.
Yeah.
Great. So, speaking of... we will wipe to... to Nolshay and Zex. You guys are at the far end of the building. Kind of walked over there. You're going to turn back around. Kind of a while walkway there, but... as you sort of pass the end of the building, kind of like in the kind of like a little bit of light, there is a figure sort of standing in the rain, about 2 meters tall, just kind of still, motionless, looking at you all.
Can I see what they're wearing?
Make a look roll.
An 18. Huh.
This figure is wearing a dark leather flight jacket, sort of blue pants.
Is the jacket really cool?
I shouldn't have said jacket. Every time I say jacket, it's not a jacket. It is.
I feel like you have to commit.
It's a leather. No. It's even more on brand. It's a leather vest. over a. Over kind of like a yellow shirt, like a pastel yellow, dark leather vest, pants. This being has green fur, and its face is kind of like Leopard Dean, and it has these two tall green ears coming out of its head.
And
it's holding a Camtono in one hand, and just sort of staring at you.
I. Look at Nolshay. Do you? This guy is looking right at us. Do you know this dude?
No, I don't. And I don't think I've ever seen that species before. Let's just
both of you. Go ahead, Nolshay.
Oh, let's just pretend like we're taking just a stroll. And not cause that thing to come closer.
So you guys carry on along the side?
Let's just, walk casual.
Yeah. And casual. By the way, I'm not. Like carrying my blaster, like
So basically, you guys sort of turn and start walking in the opposite direction. In the distance, you can sort of see through the rain. You see Zaz and Bug like crouching down or doing God knows what. Or Bug is probably not crouching, but Zaz.
Can I calm them?
You can calm. I assume everyone has comms. Sure, but. When you guys, after you guys take a few steps, you hear a single splash behind you.
I will turn.
That green
with my hand on my
the green
blaster.
Figure is standing still, but is now like a meter closer.
We're looking at him. My hand's like on my blaster, my holster, and I'm just kind of backing up a little bit tentatively, a little slowly. Things are clearly tense. Do a side glance at Nolshay, see if she's looking back a little bit like.
Yeah, I'm just like, I'm staying with my eyes, just.
Yeah, like.
Try to stay cool as we're both like gripping our blasters.
And it's just staring.
I think it's just both of us like.
It's just staring.
Like, they shouldn't be like, you sure you don't know this guy? If he's an ex-boyfriend, say something now.
Hi. Do you speak basic? Okay, I guess not.
Speak
well.
Galactic standard.
Wonderful. What brings you to this part of town?
I am the Egg de Lepim.
Excuse me?
I'm the Egg de Lepim.
Egderleppy.
Kind of leans forward. You see there's this like scar on his face. And he just says, I am the Egg de Lepim.
Oh, Egg de Lepim. Odd. Well, tis the season. You know,
Happy Egg Day.
Happy Egg Day. Meanwhile, Zip, you smell something on the air. Please make a taste smell roll.
46.
I believe that's a success for you. You do think that there is a small creature like within your scent range. It's kind of, it can be a little hard to tell in the rain, but you're sort of sniffing around and you think something's approaching. Would you please make you know its general sort of direction. You think it's a few meters away. It's up on this roof. Why don't you make a look roll kind of to sort of like peer through?
5.
Wow. Okay. That's an extreme success. Great.
Extreme successful.
Sort of near you, you see a small sort of like pink furred bunny.
I don't trust it.
It's like this small, it's got like a backpack on, but as it sort of notices you noticing it turns blue. It takes a few steps forward, it says, how you doing?
I pull out my blaster.
Oh.
Not a step, bunny.
I don't step.
Freeze, bunny.
I ain't a bunny. I'm
a... Not a hop.
Cushy bun. I'm the cushy bun. I'm the egg day cushy bun. You really want to threaten the egg day cushy bun on egg day? Is that really something you want to have done?
Yes.
I get it. Want to make a name for yourself. Be a big shot, huh? Again, this is a tiny, tiny bunny, but it is talking.
Mm-hmm. I don't trust
the
tiny
bunny's
talking
fur
bunnies.
Starts going from purple, and then it's becoming red. I get it. Go ahead, big shot. Make my egg day. Nolshay and Zex.
Can I calm the others?
Sure. So at this point, Nolshay, you were reaching for a calm. Now you get a calm from Zip. Zip, what do you say?
Hostile pink bunny on roof.
Did you say pink bunny on roof?
I guess so. We've got a big one here.
That's not a pink bunny. That's my friend, Egg Day Kushiban.
Oh, interesting. Well, happy Egg Day. I don't know how you celebrate, but may you have many happy returns.
That is not the saying.
Okay.
Well, you know, this is our first egg day, so we're a little new.
Yeah.
But we're happy to learn. I mean, is egg day not about peace?
No.
Oh, is it about not peace? Is it about violence?
Egg
what
day.
Is egg day?
He pulls up his Camtono and twists the lid. Like steam pours out of the top of it. Kind of like that, like, you know, you're not sure if it's cold or hot, but it's intense.
Yeah.
Bug and Zaz, you heard this. You can even see the two of them over on the side. What are you guys up to?
What do you think, Zaz? You think we should go over there? You think they got this?
I think one of these containers has got to have something. Like, what I mean, is that's... this? Like, you just... Who buys all this? What are you doing with this?
I mean, that's a fair... Well, I mean, it is storage. It's not like... These are not like
haven't you seen the holo vids? Like, they open the storage, there's all this cool stuff in there.
Yeah, but you know that those vids are only doing, like, the most exciting ones. There's, like, 90 failures for those one successes.
Well, how many units are we talking about in here?
I don't know.
There's probably 20 on this thing. And then there's, like, a ton of other ones around the area.
Do you want to at least send your droid over to investigate one of these things?
Like another room?
I mean, like...
Utini. Utini. Droid starts pointing. Right. Oh, actually, Zaz, your droid starts pointing at, like, one, like, a little, like, the one on the other side of the lizard skin one. And you know this droid gesture to be like, I've got a good servo about this. You know?
Oh.
Utini.
Torque thinks we should go there.
Utini.
All right.
You want to, you want to go check on them, Tor? We'll check this one out for you.
Utini.
You can't open it anyways. You'll be fine.
I will at this point, though, I will pull out my electro staff.
Okay. All right, so we'll do up top. The red bunny is staring at you, Zip. The red coochie bun. Yeah. You gonna be the big being here, huh? Gonna shoot me? Is that what you're gonna do?
Walk away and there will be no trouble. I'll hop away, little bunny.
You want me to hop away?
Yes.
So you don't want your egg?
Mm-hmm.
You don't want your egg, huh?
What egg? What are you talking about, bunny?
I'm the egg day Kushiban, ain't I?
Mm-hmm. What is the equivalent of insight over here?
Psychology is like... insight. Yeah, so it's under, oh, okay. It's down at the bottom of the first
psychology?
Column of mental talents. Yes, psychology.
Okay. I rolled 20.
20?
And
oh.
That is a very good success for me.
Awesome. Yes, that is a, that's a hard success. So, as you're sort of looking at this weird little thing. This thing seems like it kind of wants you to shoot at it so it can, like, retaliate. And there's definitely menace. It is definitely intimidating, but you don't think it's going to, like, attack you, you know? Like,
okay.
If you fire, it might get into it with you somehow, but...
But do I think that he is something that the guy is trying to summon, or is he trying to stop? Is
that
he lying
is something
to me?
Else. Why don't you make a lore roll? And that is over in your knowledge.
Crap, 87.
So you just don't understand. You just don't know what the hell is going on down there. It's so weird. You have no sense. That guy was so weird. The mm-hmm. stuff he said about Egg Day, the stuff he said about the Fellowship of Kuru, all that stuff, his little phrases about like the way of Kuru is the way of peace, the eggs, you have no understanding of what he's up to.
Okay.
So you can't tell. But this thing's just like, go ahead. What are you going, you're just kind of saying walk away still, you're just...
I'm just, we're in a standoff. I'm not, I shoot if he attacks, but I don't attack first. So yeah, just.
No egg for you. The Kushiban turns purple and then blue again. He then turns around, does like a half hop, then stops and looks back over his shoulder and says, "Your loss." Yeah. Turns back. Hops back the way it came. The green Leppy is staring at Nolsha and Zex. The Camtono's open. No one's coming for you, apparently, because they'd rather play Storage Wars.
We sent Tor.
Oh, Tor. Actually, no, you do hear Tor walking up behind you. That's fair. I take that back. They're not totally disinterested in what's happening.
Someone's got to watch the unit.
That's what we're doing.
The Leppy reaches in. You guys have your hands on your blasters?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you doing anything?
No.
We're still, I want to see what's in this thing.
He pulls out a brightly colored egg-shaped cake.
What?
I'm very confused.
That? He hops, landing like within a meter from you. And he hands you the cake.
I'm gonna take the cake.
He reaches in. Yours is orange. He hands one to Nolshe that is pink with like blue frosting.
Thank you.
Happy is this
egg day?
You too.
Happy egg day. Thank you.
Hop.
Do you want
egg day?
Ah. Hoppy. Ah.
Hoppy. That's a joke. That's funny.
Very clever. Love it. Thank you for including us in your celebrations.
Where is the acolyte?
The what?
Excuse me?
Where is the acolyte?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
We're just on a casual little walk here.
Mm-hmm.
He reaches into the Camtono, and then you hear more stuff, more like steam coolants billowing out. He pulls out a gold leaf painted cake, which he holds out. One of you will have to take a hand off a blaster to take this cake.
One of those cakes gonna explode, I just know it.
He hands it to you, Zex, and says, "Give that to Ecolette." And now he's blurry in the rain, you can't hear him.
That actually makes sense.
Are the cakes just like dripping?
Just holding yeah, basically. Oh, yeah,
somebody left a cake out in the rain and cannot find a
way. It is MacArthur Park, melting in the dark. Sweet cream icing flowing down. never have that recipe again.
I'm just palming two cakes in the rain. Just all right. Is the bunny guy still here, or did he?
He's just glaring at both.
Dramatic. I'm gonna like look at Nolshe, like give her like, let's.
They happy, and she'll like do a weird like curtsy bow thing. Say happy hoppy egg day.
And then you hear a splash next to you, as a small blue bunny lands next to the guy and looks up at you and goes, "Hoppy egg day? That's disrespectful."
Well, not according to this person.
The bunnies are being confusing.
And he just goes, "Neither of us are bunnies. I am Leppy. He is Kushiban."
Leppy and Kushiban. Okay.
We are the egg day Leppy and Kushiban.
My apologies.
Sorry. Do you work together or separate? I'm assuming because you say hoppy.
They look at each other when you say that they work together or separately. The Leppy just glares down at the Kushiban, and the Kushiban just glares up at him. And then, in unison, after like a pregnant pause, they both say, "Together, together." And then they turn.
Oh no!
And hop away. 3 meters at a time. By the fourth hop, you can't see them anymore in the rain.
Do they hop the same distance despite the size difference?
Yeah, they're hopping in. They're tandem.
So hopping. Basically, the little bunny is the real deal.
You don't even see. Actually, you could have seen this if you follow the bunny when he went? Did you like see where he was going?
Would you stay? Keep an eye on him, obviously.
Well, it's hard from where you are. It's hard to see like over the thing because you're on the roof. But if you like moved over to look, you would have. You suspect that the green one could hop further. They're purposefully hopping, and, like, you know. They're hopping from street lamp to street lamp.
I would like to calm the others and say, guys, a large leppy gave us egg cakes.
You see, Zex, as you're standing there, Torg moves his giant, like, plated arm over the two cakes, just so, like, they're not being rained on. Although thanks, a little Torg. Bit of, like, motor oil drops onto the one of them.
I'll have it be mine.
Utini.
Thanks, Thor.
What's a leppy, and what do you mean by egg cakes?
I don't know, and I also don't know, really. This one looks to be orange with blue frosting. That's all I can tell you.
Have you tried them?
I'm afraid.
Is there something in it?
We don't know.
We're coming back to you.
Yeah.
In the meantime, Zaz, are you opening the one that your friend told you to open?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Make another sleight of hand check. Bad news.
12.
Or not fine, yeah, not sleight of hand, fine motor skills, you know what I'm saying. Yeah, you know, yeah. I see what's going on with Zaz. You know what Zaz is, you know what the one thing Zaz is real good at, right? Is freaking that. Is got a bonus on all those. So, yeah. Hence these extreme vitals. Yeah, it was your. So basically, you.
I practiced hands.
Because you've done this so many times, you don't even have to score vitals to prevent the beep, and you open it, and this one contains a bunch of droid casings. Okay, here's what it contains. It contains chest plates and like butt plates. That are either very like muscled male forms or like busty female forms, and the butts are all incredibly chiseled.
Okay.
Something Torg's not telling you?
Eh. He goes into this stuff all the time.
Okay.
Everyone's got their thing, right?
Does any of it look valuable?
Can I do anything with any of this?
I mean, you know, you're always putting droids together. These are perfectly fine pieces. It's like a, you know, it's like if you find art, like if it's a Mapplethorpe, does that make it harder for you to move or easier? You know, it just depends. You're not sure, but these are some droids who are meant to be like stacked or jacked.
Grab a few.
At any point, Torg kind of walks over and sort of sees this, and actually, like, Zex and Nolsha, you can, like, step in out of the rain to this empty facility. And as you're sort of getting in out of the rain and the cakes aren't being leaked on, but when Torg sees this, he sort of moves away from this and looks in and goes, "Utini." He takes his like socket eyes off and goes, and they stick out on like the things like.
Yeah, I told you stop doing that. I have to fix that when you do this.
Utini. He like pulls like a bunch of wires out of his mouth and rolls them like it's like a wolf tongue.
Oh god,
stop. You're going very toony on this.
He's a robot. He can do it. Zip also mentioned you up on top. You do hear from the thing, the chanting is becoming very intense, and it's like there is still some singing, but then it's just becoming like this very frantic, like Kuru Ovagoras 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 Yeah Ovagoras, and you hear like slapping sounds. It's weird. So Zip, if you want to do anything with that, otherwise you could just keep your position.
Can I make it any way that I can actually see what's going on?
You don't think, like, if you were that Kushiban who came and talked to you, and you could stop the fan, you might be able to climb down through that vent, but there's no way you can fit as, like, a sort of human-ish sized creature. But so meanwhile, so Nolshe, you're just there with a cake in the rain.
So,
Zex has
two.
No, we're inside.
Yeah, you're in. It had been in the rain, but now it's there. Yeah, you guys are fine.
And are we with Bug and Zaz now? Okay. So these are the cakes. I think the gold one is for our friend in there. Yeah.
Well, we should try that one first.
You can, here, take it. Go ahead. No, we're not going to take the gold one. That is for the one inside. Can we have something?
I mean,
is that as you want a cake?
I'm just going to point out something. Like, I mean, we can hang on to him. We can ask him about it, I guess, when he comes out. But, like, he thought someone was going to come interrupt him, and then some creature showed up and handed you a cake for him.
Right.
Very threatening previews.
Should we trust him?
What kind of crackpot did you guys find?
It could be a poison cake. Oh, wait, I'm not there.
It had too long. I don't know. Here, somebody take this cake. I don't want it.
Torque, you can have it.
Can I take the cake and...
I'm going to give one to the bug.
Can I take one of the cakes and smell it? This is a weird smell request, but to smell it, to see if I smell anything like non-food-like.
Make a smell taste. Sure.
Our cakes. Sure.
I understand you're not tasting it, but you go for it. Make the roll.
Oh, Nolshe, we have something to show you, too.
Regular success. Oh, yeah, we need you to look at something real quick.
Okay.
Yeah.
It smells like a cake. You can smell sort of sweet and various, you know, vanilla scents or other sort of common flavorings.
Mm. I mean, it just sort of smells like a cake.
Try it.
I guess one of us should try it, maybe, I guess?
Yeah.
All right, who's going to do it?
Not me.
Jawas can't eat cake.
I don't really like sweet things.
So it's me or Nolshe.
Although, wait.
Well, they are your cakes, right?
It is shaped like an egg, and according to the Mandalorian, they really do like eating giant eggs.
Huh?
That is true.
So it's me, Zaz, or Nolshe. Who's going to try a cake? Does rock, paper, scissors exist in the Star Wars universe?
I already refused.
I feel like that's not good enough.
It'd probably be called like speeder, blaster, I don't know. But
nobody needs to eat these cakes.
I feel like we
can save all three for him when he's done. I'm sure he'll be very hungry. What did you guys want me to look at? And I'll set the cake
onto
just put it in one of these chassis.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're curious if something we found would be used for clothing or designs.
Okay.
You're the expert of that. Zaz, do you want to show her?
Yeah. Okay. Take some of these chassis with us.
Zaz, do you also set your cake? So do we set, basically, hey guys, do we set the cakes on some cakes, if you know what I mean?
Okay. Sure.
There's just some like super chiseled like buns, like Van Damme buns looking like I'm why anyone would have that be the plate. But you guys put some cakes on that and yeah, you can head over to the...
Cake on a cake.
You guys can head over to the facility, which since you've already opened it, you can do so again. Nolshe, you are hit with a wave of horrible
odor. Open it and run back.
Oof.
And there are a bunch of like hastily carved off lizard skins.
Oh wow. Okay, I'll do a roll fashion design.
You can do fashion.
Oh, no. Or what about either fashion design or clothing fabrication? Oh, that's an act. Never mind.
No. I think in this context, clothing fabrication might actually, I mean, you have the same, go ahead and do clothing fabrication. That's because you're really, it's not so much the design. You're wondering, could these be used for clothes?
Yeah. Ooh, it just got lower and lower. A 13.
That is and that was with your two bonuses.
Yeah.
Nice. With a 13, so click your box on that. Way to go. With a very extreme success, this is not, like, fashion-grade fabric. You need to tan the material pretty quickly if you're going to try to be using it for, like, treat it. However, it might not be tanning for lizard skin, but you get the idea.
Yeah.
In addition, you too recognize that there are some, like sentient creature skins here.
So it'd be which completely immoral.
Typically, people don't make clothing out of them, illegal. Although you do know there are some Trandoshan skins here, and you do know the Trandoshans do sometimes kill Wookiee and wear Wookiee fur.
Uh-huh.
So, tell you what, make a, with your extreme success, I'd like for you to roll a sciences.
Hmm.
A what?
Sciences and knowledge, sciences general.
Hold on. I failed.
you're not sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I do know they are not appropriate.
This
for
is not anything. This is not like a this is not a lizard tannery's like salon, like someone's just yeah. This is some
okay.
Yeah.
These are not suitable for anyone to wear and questionable because we do have some sentient beings that were killed. It might have been another species that also commonly kills them, and they were, the Wookiees might have gotten to them. They wear Wookiee fur sometimes. I have no idea what's going on, but no, absolutely not. You cannot use these for anything. They would have had to be tanned closer to the time of death. I need to get out of here. I can't.
And also, like, that arm that's still in that one, you know, you wouldn't keep the arms in it. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, these are not, no. I have to go.
Cool. So, Zaz, what I heard there is that Wookiees might want to buy this.
Yeah, I was about to ask, like, could I possibly roll to see if I know who would want to buy this?
Zex, oh, why don't you do a culture roll? Yeah, make a culture roll, Zex. Meanwhile, Zip is on the roof.
I got a 16.
16. Ooh, that's pretty good.
Just hard.
You know what? Shoot, Zex. You're from Nathor, which means you do have a Wookiee constituency. So you know what that means? Upon hearing what she's saying and looking in, you look and you notice how many arms are still under the skin here, and you realize a Wookiee did this.
Wait.
Nasty little buggers.
The job of a Wookiee.
No, so this is a Wookiee stash?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think this is a Wookiee.
Close it up. I want to.
Nalshay's dry heaving outside, but says, I told you.
Oh, actually, I'll tell you what. Zaz, make another luck roll.
All right.
We might have pissed off a Wookiee, guys. All right.
A nine.
Zaz, you kind of like, just like glance at like the thing and we'll even say that as you're just like looking around, you happen to like stumble and you see a little like credit receipt. This facility is owned by someone named B. Kersantin.
Oh. Okay.
Is that from the Book of Boba Fett?
Yeah, and also from the comics. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, it's him.
Is it the Wookiee?
Yeah,
the black Wookiee. The bounty hunter
and
Wookiee.
And his hobbies include murdering Trandoshans because they made him fight in like the slave pits for so long. So he likes to find them and skin them and rip off their arms, sometimes in that order. Oh, and kill them. You get the idea. Skins them alive. That's all that's happening. All right, so you smell that. At this point, Zip. The chanting has stopped, and you do hear more sort of slapping sounds, but now you hear the singing has resumed once again. Kuru, Kuru, Ovagores Venai, Deus Ex Machina, etc., etc. And then, kind of like, he sounds very tired.
Do I think that it's winding down at last?
Make another psychology roll.
Ooh, 78.
With a
78. That is not a success.
You just cannot tell. But at this point, as sort of the night wears on, you guys have looked into some stuff. No one's going to taste the cakes.
At at this point, Nolshay is unable to consume anything.
I understand. That's fair. That room was rough.
Really got to her.
I'm not near the cakes, so it's not.
Yeah, you're doing the thing. Yeah, Bug, you had a question.
Well, I will let Zex go. I think he was going to say something. So
I'm going to continue the tradition of characters of mine, and I'm going to be bold and try one of the cakes.
All right. Are you trying the one that the one you were handed? The I think you
the had one the, that was handed. Yeah, not the gold one.
You take a bite, kind of back over in the thing. It's just on all the stuff. And Torg is, you told Torg to take a few of these chassis, so Torg's still in there, just like holding them up, and he's basically just getting like the most like yoked dudes he can find, and just like holding those up against himself. He is not the right size for this, so it would be like a giant thing with like a tiny like torso like that big on the front of it, if you were to try to put this on, but that's like, or maybe you could do like two of them, but then he looks like multiple guys, it's upsetting. But he's like holding them up. And like trying and like or like turning them around where there's a more reflective surface and like looking at himself in like a weird like convex shape of what he looks like. As you come back in, Zex, you pick up one of the cakes, you take the bite. Yours has a faint carrot flavor. It seems very well made and has good mouthfeel, nice chew to it. It's not overbaked. No soggy bottom. Yeah. You think it might be a little overly sweet. There also are like jelly beans inside of it. Like, so like there's kind of a yeah, but it's a well-made cake.
It's not bad. Guys, these cakes actually aren't bad.
How about the other one?
The gold one? Nah.
We're not... Save that one.
That's for the weirdo inside.
What if we transport it and then, like, some comes off on your hand? And, like, you're not going to put that back on it, right? You just want to...
Taste it?
Bear in mind, all of these horrible things are being said to you by, like, a 2-foot-tall Jawa who's... It's all coming out of, like, a vocoder box.
What if some comes off on the side? Would you not just taste it? Would you not put it back on? Would you? Yeah.
This Jawa is my kind of scum.
All right. Do you taste the gold, or you're holding off on the gold?
I'm not going to taste the gold.
Understood. But the cake.
I'll taste a little finger of it.
The smooth the icing out there. Sure.
Yeah.
You get from the gold a distinct, if you're just having a little taste, well, roll a smell taste for me. Zex, you were just taking a bite, you're eating it as intended, but Zaz is kind of just getting a little.
Oh, I actually got a success.
Oh, nice.
A 12.
Zaz, what is your score in that? 25?
15.
15, oh, yikes. So yeah, you take a little bite. It is, you can tell that it is, there is like an intoxicant in this one. Like this one has this is a boozier kind of cake. You know what I mean?
Oh.
It's like you smell it as you get closer, like, oh wow, this one's got some, you know, some
Boganoga cake.
There's probably some Boganoga in this cake, exactly. And at that point, Zip. We'll have to roll this. At this point, I need all five of you to make a luck roll. Let's see what kind of egg day we can have.
I got a 14.
You may use a force point to give yourself a bonus or to even reroll. Yes, you could.
Oh, I got a hard success.
Hard success. Thank you, Nolshay.
If I use a force point, do I have to keep the new one?
No, you can to re-roll, you mean? You get to choose which one you want.
Oh, okay.
And if you re-roll, you get your bonus on the re-roll as well.
Okay, bonus. What bonus?
So whenever you make a luck roll, you get to roll with a bonus or advantage, as we call it in. The reason I say a bonus, though, is because you can buy extra, like, unlike D&D, if you want to spend a force point before you do it, you can have two bonuses. It's not like advantage where you only get one. Like you can spend it so you get to roll four of these at once, you know?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's a difference between this game. You can stack a roll way in your favor.
Nice. And what is about roll d20 when improving luck?
That's improving is the thing we do at the end of the game. That's not for this. That's kind of a weird feat for you to have because it's a thing, but you still get the bonus on it too, which is cool.
All right. And I have a 19 then.
19, which for you is a hard success, right?
I think so. What is my luck?
Bug, what did you have?
I'll find it.
I rolled a
22,
which is one shy of a hard success.
Okay. Normal success. Zex, what did you have for your luck roll?
A 50.
50. Okay, so probably a success, but not. Or actually for you, that might not even be a success.
It's just a normal success.
Zaz, what did we have?
Hard success.
Hard success. So a bunch of hards, but no extreme. Understood. So, you guys, wait for the rain to pass, wait for this job, keep an eye out. You don't see anyone else come down this path. But then, zip, you hear, actually make another listen roll. Let's see how much you can hear for this one. Over the boom, 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 boom of the fan.
I don't hear anything. I rolled a 78.
Understood. So at this point, Zip, you're probably, you know what? You probably just hear these idiots down here talking about like tasting the cake and like, no, reshape the frosting. So it's like that. And after a few hours, the gate opens to the facility you're watching. If you guys, you can, you're only two doors over, you can sort of head to that or whatever. Zip, you're above it, but he sort of steps out and says, oh, hello, good, thank you so much for making sure I had no interruptions,
Yeah, somebody, I think, dropped off a gift for you, and I'll get the egg.
Who dropped this off?
It was me.
No, it was not him.
Hello.
It was a large green, what are they called again?
Leppy.
And Cushy.
The Egg Day Leppy and the Egg Day Cushy Bun?
Yeah, and this is for you.
They were here? Oh, yeah. Why didn't you tell? Oh, because I told you not to, but, oh, I wish you'd interrupted me. I would have loved to see them. Oh, they're real?
Apparently.
Did they hop? Were they nice? Did they fill you with Egg Day cheer?
They were not nice. I'm at the edge of the roof looking down. They were not nice.
What color was the Cushy bun?
The yellow one wasn't.
What color was the Cushy bun? Was he funfetti? Was he all the colors? Was he white with all the dots?
Oh, wow.
No, it was purple, and then it was pink.
Yeah, we saw
and then
pink.
And it was red at the end.
And red in...
Red means angry.
Oh, that's because we implied that he and the Leppy worked together. But he did not like that.
They do.
Oh. They don't seem super hoppy about that. Here, take this. I would not like to hold this anymore. Thank you. Here you go.
They said they'd wait for you in that unit over there.
No, they didn't.
But they said this was for me?
Yes.
You specifically, yeah.
Did they know my name?
No, they called you the Exol... What did they...
Acolyte?
Acolyte, but it should have been the Egg... It should have been the Egg-colyte.
Egg-colyte.
Yes.
Yep.
Then, though, this Egg Day... It was not a full, complete success, but it still, I did enough to keep Egg Day alive. And he gestures back to the glowing egg in there. It will continue until next year. And then perhaps we will hatch and the Kuru will hatch again. Oh. And you guys can all see as the pupils just dilate. Oh, thank you.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Thank you, friends.
Yeah,
can we go?
well, we gotta get
our... Your payment, of course. And right. Yeah, there were... There's not 10 of you. That one's
yeah. Oh, there is actually. Yeah,
yeah,
there,
is.
Yeah there are. There
well,
are.
So we hired some more people to make sure that the guarding would be.
We really wanted you to be protected.
There's the. I see you. I'm seeing double. Just there like are, I see yeah. both your Lepi and Kushiban forms. Oh, what a joyous egg day this is! And kind of just
joyous,
goes to
wonderful.
The goes to the thing and does hand to all. Actually,
I'll roll for this.
Strictly speaking, Zaz, why don't you roll for this?
All right, what am I rolling?
Luck.
All right.
When in doubt, roll luck.
Why not? Yeah. He's a bonus too, because
like this seems like the end, so let's burn him.
Hard success.
So basically, hands like little pieces of artwork collected, all approximately 1,500 credits retail value to each of you. But
just one. Oh,
just one each, but does also give one to Torg, and pats the metal breastplate Torg is holding, and it's like so strong. Oh yes, sir. Thank you. Oh, you know, so just saw humanoid musculature and was like sure, and Torg just goes utini. Torg starts squeezing whatever he was handed, but he says thank you so much. I'm going to rest now. Thank you for guarding. I appreciate this. I you just know that the way of Kuru is the way to peace. Can you see the peace?
I see that you are seeing a lot of things, can and you? Maybe you should sit down, have some it water, and enjoy one. Your time.
Have you ever seen an yeah, egg some more peace. Being laid?
No.
Yes.
Lucky egg.
Well,
the egg got lucky.
Of course, that's a crazy place.
That's. We all come from eggs, even mammals, you know. He just kind of goes back into his room.
Is
kind
of, can I? Can we see into his room while he's
yeah.
out here?
Yeah, it's just it's totally empty. There's like two crates, and there is an egg next to like an open crate that it was in. Yeah, go ahead.
A minute. I'm gonna elbow bug.
Yeah.
Can I use that. Deceive to try to get more reward?
You suspect that at this point, this guy's like, he's in another dimension.
Yeah, he's mentally vulnerable.
So he's probably just like, he's just going in there to continue reveling in the gift. Yeah. He really wishes you guys had opened it up for him. He really would have loved to meet those. He's well, not mad because he knows he told you not to, but he's like, next year he's gonna hire people and be like, please guard me and don't let anyone in except
Lepi.
The Egg Day Lepi and the Egg Day.
It's the one time we should have listened to Zaz.
Yeah.
Just opened it.
There's that's only valuable to him.
The egg.
Yeah.
Well, happy Egg Day, everyone. Should we go back to the bar?
Egg Day.
Can I whisper something to Zaz?
Sure.
And just ask, did you take her bike apart?
What color is hers?
Can I roll to see if I know that?
I think it was already determined that he did not, but it is.
Oh, okay.
It is
always
I know
it was determined.
Okay, so,
I thought he said he did.
So as you all sort of emerge back there, 1,500 credits richer, if you go back to Haldir's, you can all drink, I don't know, anything that doesn't have eggs in it, presumably, and enjoy what you got to experience, rather than no. going to a super exclusive music festival, wine and food, puppy party. I don't know what all was there.
You know, when you get rid of Kyle and Haldir and pretty much every customer in this bar, it's not so bad.
Ladies and gentlemen, the power converters. A boom 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 boom. Hey, come on, Corellia, let's go around the bound. Corellian swing is going around. And you see a bunch of young Corellian guys come in and start screaming and just doing their Corellian dancing, and they're all dancing on the bar. And one of them screams, "I'm gonna live forever."
I stand corrected.
And with that. we'll close out our Egg Day celebration. Well done,
Happy
everyone.
Happy Egg Day.
a peek behind the curtain. I'm actually very glad Kevin was able to join for this. Egg Day was invented, I guess, 2 years ago on Easter. I was running a Sunday night Star Wars game off stream, and they were on a planet called Vaini, and there was this cult. This was like, Vaini's a planet. I was using a lot of stuff from like the old West End game stuff. Vaini was a planet from that, and the Cult of Kuru was on it. And I decided the Cult of Kuru shall be egg-based. So that was born from that stuff. But they did
Illyria barely made it out of Egg Day.
Yeah, but that was not because of Egg Day. You guys picked some weird... Anyway, Illyria did also meet, but she met the Kushiban and the...
She did.
But they were much... It was different then. That was thousands of years ago. The point being...
Yeah.
Thousands. Is that where the children fixed our ship?
Yep, that's where the children fixed your ship at the Academy. and that was... I was actually rereading because I used to write... I used to write more, basically Asha, that was KJ's character in that game, had a medical droid. And so she had the medical droid, drug all the children into sleep on Egg Day, on the night before Egg Day, and then perform all the much needed procedures that all of the orphans who worked at this shop needed. And they were open to suddenly delighted cries filled the area as the children awoke to find many of their medical problems were miraculously solved. My foot, it works. It's an Egg Day miracle. I can see out of both eyes. Thanks, Egg Day Leppy. Hey, it doesn't feel like agonizing fire to breathe anymore. And look, everybody, my pee isn't red. These were the shouts shouted by the children of Vaini on that Egg Day. And then Asha took her credits and candy. anyway. Well, thanks for joining us here on this Easter night. Now, this was a rapid one, but I had a lot of fun doing this. If you like what we do here, I'm sorry. I don't know what to tell you, but keep coming back and watch it, I guess. We have other games on this channel. Tomorrow night, we have Lost Lore Academia. That's our kind of meta game about all the other games. On Tuesday, this week, we have nothing. We might have a thing on Wednesday that is still pending. But typically on Tuesdays, we have Gray in the Dark, our noir black and white game. On Friday, we have Blood from a Stone, which is in its own sort of collegiate situation now. Very kind of weird. This coming Friday is... 91, says chapter 91, a multiple of 13, and at the end of last chapter, thanks to the person directly below me on your Twitch screen,
I don't know what you're talking
Lauren
about.
Lauren rolled a Dreadstorm, and then rolled again, so she rolled a 13 that triggered the Dreadstorm, then she rolled a 13 that triggered a Horror Surge, and we were just like, let's stop it there and start strong next week.
Oh, excellent.
So
that's
gonna be a big one. That may be the end of Medina. Come and join us for that. And then a week from tonight, we'll be back with our dragon game. But 2 weeks from tonight, we'll be back with more Mystic Starport fun, getting up to, whatever silliness these people get up to every time. You can follow us, please, and then subscribe if you are able. Go to our Discord. We do a lot of stuff there. Lauren, do you want to plug?
I have started streaming on my own channel again, Thursdays at 7 or 7:30 approximately.
Very cool. Anybody else want to mention stuff, plug stuff?
Sure. I will just do this as a Star Wars recommendation. Given all of the announcements, from Celebration, I've recommended it before, but that you check out, Timothy Zahn's Heir to the Empire trilogy. Because a lot of that information is going to start getting tapped and pulled into this in various little homages and ways, I think, with the Ahsoka show, with Dave Filoni's movie, and possibly even into like the movie with Rey. So great book by one of the best Star Wars writers, and narrated, if you're an audiobook person, narrated by probably the best Star Wars narrator, Mark Thompson. So, and you can get it all for free at your libraries. Check libraries.
That is the nice thing about 30-year-old books.
Libraries the best thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, awesome. Thank you, everyone. This was super fun. Thanks also, everyone, for watching. And it seemed like chat was having a lot of fun tonight. I don't have chat up just all the time.
There were so many egg puns in the beginning.
Yes, this is excellent.
To the point where I think that I'm suspecting that Dan just made a lot of alt accounts tonight.
You know what? All I have to say is that really, guys, that really lived up to my expectations.
Nailed it.
Because I didn't do
great job.
What you expected me to say, expectations that I didn't. Thank you all so much. This was super fun. We're going to head out now, blasting off to whatever port the Outrider finds itself in. But until then, just remember, the Force will be with you. Always. Ba 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 ba.
Good night.